Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Choosing the university you want to study in. What a difficult thing to do. If deciding what is it that you wanted to study was not hard enough, after you have decided on which degree you want to study, you are not done yet. You still need to choose in which specific university you want to study that degree on. I mean, I still remember when I had to make that choice. There are so many things that come into play. You can choose from private universities, public ones. You can study in one city, in another, maybe also in a different country. There are also different structure when it comes to the education, different subjects despite studying the same degree, just to mention some of the many things that come into play whenever making this decision. In today's video, I'm only certain of one thing, which is that unfortunately I won't be able to give you answers to all the questions that you might have. I mean, if you have questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below and I will do my best to answer them all and give you feedback. But unfortunately, this is something, or this topic is very personal. However, what I will do is that I will give you a list of the most important aspects that I personally would consider, and I also considered back then whenever selecting a university. And this way, with this list, you can go point by point, analyzing and comparing the different universities that maybe you have in mind at the moment. And once you have all of that and you are able to compare the different points, hopefully you are also able to make a more informed decision and a better one when it comes to selecting the university that better fits your needs. Anyways, before we dive into the video, I would first of all like to thank the sponsor of today's video, College Life. College Life is a hub with more than 180,000 international students and graduates from all over the world that provides great support in many different aspects surrounding the choice of the university, amongst other things. But more about that later on in the video. Firstly, before we get into the different topics, I personally already graduated about a year ago in hotel management, which is essentially like a business administration degree, but more focused on the tourism industry and more concretely on hotels. And currently I am working in the HR department of an international e-commerce company with headquarters in Germany, but we also have offices in Spain, Italy, the UK, and US. However, I must say that if I now had to choose a degree, and this is something that I already mentioned in other videos, I would probably not choose the exact same one, but I would go for a business administration one. And why exactly would I do that? Well, because although I like the tourism industry, it is not the only one out there, and I also love seeing and learning how different industries operate and also make money, of course. And then we also have the point that if you know that you want to work in business but are not sure exactly in which industry you want to work in, a business administration degree gives you a much more general and broader scope, while the tourism one is much more specific to just the tourism industry. In light of this, I would say if you know for sure that you want to work in the tourism industry, then probably a hotel hospitality management degree is better for you because you are already targeting that industry and you might have higher chances of getting hired there. But if you're not sure of which exact industry you want to work in, but you know for sure that you want to do business, then I would certainly go for a business administration one. Important though, although the degree that you study is certainly important and in most of the cases it will end up having a very big impact on your future, career and life, it is not the only determinant. And actually, the person who will determine where your life takes you is just you and the decisions that you take throughout it, not just what you study. I just thought that I would leave this very clear. There are of course other aspects as well that go into your professional life. Some of them, maybe I will be mentioning them throughout this video. But with that said, let's go and see the different aspects that I would consider whenever choosing a specific university to study a degree. Point number one. Which job opportunities do I have access to after finishing the degree in that specific university? Obviously, at the end of the day, you can study something and then end up doing something completely different, and that's okay. But keep in mind that aligning your studies with your future career path can give you a more attractive CV and give you better chances of success over maybe other candidates within that specialty that you were trying or focused on. Also, then we need to consider that there are for certain degrees or jobs that you might want to take, like for instance, becoming a doctor. Unless you have a degree in that specific thing, there is no way that you will become one. The good thing though about the business world is that it is much more flexible, so even if you study something different, you can always redirect your career path through gaining professional experience in other fields. On the topic of business opportunities, I would go farther than just looking at the job titles itself, but I would also check which are the average salaries for the different positions that you can aim towards after finishing the degree. And let's be honest, we all want to earn as much as possible for our time or the job that we perform. So of course, knowing the average salaries of the jobs that we want to aim towards after finishing the degree, I think it's super important and can give us proper expectations. On it, luckily for all of us, internet makes all of this information much more available. Of course, there are different numbers out there, and you also need to understand that the average are just averages, but there are many different companies and there can be big differences between one and the other. And then on this topic of salaries, something also interesting is that sometimes or very often universities also publish which is the average salary that their graduates are getting. And you can also use that to compare different universities to see where these stand. I would not use this as the main determinant, but if there's one university that clearly stands out from the rest, then probably it's interesting to have a closer look at that. Also, most likely it will be more expensive, but it is also something that I personally would consider. Let's go now into point number two, and for me, one of the most important ones, because this is what might end up getting you extremely far within the business world. And that is connections. How many connections can you build in your university, or how much networking can you do? And why do I say this? Well, essentially connections are vital, and even if people maybe don't want to admit it, it is great having lots of connections. And personally, I have gotten several job offers thanks to having built connections while I was at university. That most of them have not been interesting for me, and I have just denied them, yes. But who knows, maybe in the future, when also I have more professional experience and I have a more attractive CV, I end up getting much more attractive job offers. Who knows? But as I said, having connections opens you many more doors. Also, on networking within your university, connections can range from teachers to associates coming to give speeches, to companies when they come to try to recruit talent in maybe career days, to your colleagues. And I would specifically like to highlight your colleagues because they can be great connections, as they will also be in the professional world when you finish, same as you. And you might end up getting very good job offers precisely from them. And my advice on this, don't try to be liked by absolutely everyone and just try to be the nice guy. I mean, of course, you should be nice to absolutely everyone, but I would rather focus on being professional, showing that you're viable, that you take things seriously during your studies, because this is the impression that your classmates will get of you. And I just think to myself, if one day I become the CEO of a big multinational or a big company, or even I have my own little company, I'm looking for somebody to hire, and I look back to my class at university, I won't probably be hiring the funny guy that I got along very well, but that at the end of the day, when it came to projects and doing assignments, he or she was very lazy. Instead, I will probably look at that other person that I found very responsible, and professional. But in all of this, what exactly does the university have to do, and what would I personally look for? Well, I would try to research and see what actions is the university taking. For instance, starting with the teachers. Are the teachers just based in the university, researchers, and they just come to do classes? This might be great because the teachers might really know how to teach, and sometimes it is not just about expertise, but also about being able to communicate. But what I personally find more interesting is when teachers that have maybe their own companies just come for a few hours to teach at a university because it is something that they enjoy, and perhaps they are also screening a bit the students, maybe potentially hiring one afterwards. That's something that I personally consider interesting. Then also you could ask yourselves, is that university organizing career days maybe once or twice a year in which many different companies gather together and are there? Maybe that's also interesting. Or for instance, does the university participate in university competitions in which you can get to meet other students within the business world and maybe also enlarge your connections? And finally, do they have external speakers coming regularly to give talks about different topics? With it, we get to point number three, which are the subjects and the teachers/teaching style. As you might know, although you might study a business administration degree, it is not the same studying it in one university than the other. They have different structure and also sometimes also different subjects, although there might be some general ones that might be the same. There are also, of course, differences. And then there are different teachers, of course, that also give a different approach to those different subjects. And how would I personally investigate a bit more this topic? Of course, in the website, you have the different, or in the curriculum of the degree itself, you have the different subjects that you will be taking. But to go a bit further, I would advise you to try to contact people who have been studying in that university via three different ways. Of course, the first and most, or the easiest one is if you have a friend who is studying there, is doing that degree that you want to study, go and talk to them, go and have a coffee, or just go for a walk at the park, and then ask questions on how is the degree structured, how are the different things done, and this way you get more insights on that. If you don't know anyone, then I would advise you to go to the career day, the open doors day, the day in which the university shows the potential new students, the campuses, also they give talks, and there are usually current students that are there also to help and orientate and answer questions. So I would also try to take as much advantage of that as possible. And then option number three is to use a network like, for instance, LinkedIn. You can search there who is studying in that university and that degree, and maybe try to contact a few people through LinkedIn, ask them your questions in a nice email, and maybe they get back to you, maybe they even give you their phone number, you can have a quick call with them. But I would really ask you to use that networking and already start building those connections to get more insights on the degree and the university that you want to study in. Actually though, if you made it this far, then this means that you are really taking this topic of selecting the right university very seriously, and hopefully also you are enjoying the video. And here is where college life comes in. In the description of the video, you will find a link to log into a free business community, and yes, you heard that right, it is completely free for students who study or are interested in studying business. This community not only connects you with other business students and helps you build a network, but it also provides a lot of free content to help you make this important decision, and even has personal assistance when it comes to selecting the right business education. Moreover, College Life has guides and a lot of useful content around studying in different countries, which is honestly super helpful. That said, let's continue with point number four, the location of the university. On it, it is true that you can also do degrees fully, 100% remotely, you know, online, everything, and there has probably been an acceleration of those during the past year, but most of the universities in Europe are still planning on going back to face-to-face classes as soon as the whole pandemic that we're living goes back to more controllable levels, hopefully also very, very soon. And this means that there is a location for the university that you also need to attend to. And more than looking maybe at the city it is located in and if it is a very nice place or not, I would more than that look at the business environment. Are there a lot of job opportunities there? Just to place an example, if you wanted to study, for instance, fashion, we could have taken any other thing, but let's just say that you wanted to study something related to fashion. Probably I would not want to study it in a city like Berlin that is maybe much more tech, or in another one like Frankfurt. Instead, I would be looking to study it in cities like Milan or Paris that have a much better business environment. Many more companies have offices there. And how does this translate into your university? Well, during the university, you will have to do internships. And it is better if you are already in a city that offers lots of different job opportunities from your field. And in that case, not only it will be easier to find good internships that really can add value to you and help you grow and learn, but also maybe if you are a high performer, you really do your internship well and the company is happy with you, you have very good chances that they end up hiring you and that you can get to stay in that company. Point number five is the language of your studies, and on this, of course, it will depend on the specific ones that you choose, but I would recommend 100% to do them fully taught in English, especially within the business world. And if you want to end up working in international companies, English ends up being the main communication language across the company. So why not already study your full degree in English? Maybe if now you're watching me from an English or a native English speaking country, you might think that this is stupid, but for non-English speaking countries, especially basically almost all Europe, it is really a choice that you have. Many universities offer this, and I would certainly go for that. This doesn't mean that learning other languages or knowing other languages is not important. Absolutely not, because if you work, even if it's for an international company in Spain, and you work, for instance, in the departments of HR or finance, the laws that will apply will still be the ones from Spain, and the reporting or the things that you will have to do will end up being in Spain. So having Spanish or speaking Spanish will be essential. But on top of that, if your company is international, the communication within different employees, maybe with the headquarters or offices in other countries, will happen 100% in English. After this, the final topic that comes in is point number 6, which is money. How much money are you willing to spend on your university, on your studies, or how much money also are you able to spend on that? Do you want to choose a public or a private university? Usually, but not always this is the case, the more expensive the university or the studies, the better these are. But as I said, not necessarily this is the case, and I would certainly advise you and recommend you to do proper due diligence on all of that to see whether paying more really is worth it. I mean, there's an example which is pretty clear, which is, for instance, studying in Harvard. Harvard, I'm not super familiar with it, but it is probably one of the most expensive universities in the world. But what happens, you study there and you don't even have to look for a job afterwards. Companies come directly to you, and that is, of course, great. But not everyone in the world has the money to pay for that. Certainly, I don't have the money. With it though, we have reached the last aspect that I personally would consider whenever selecting the right university for my studies, and I really want to emphasize that the best tool here is research, and that if you really research well your different options, then I'm sure that you will make a decision that you won't regret. With it though, I will leave it for today. But wait, what? You still have not checked the free business community of College Life, which is down below in the description? Probably you were waiting for the end of the video to get all the content and then go and check that out. Well, in that case, I have good news for you, because as I said, this is the end of the video. If you enjoyed it, then please don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you are not yet subscribed, and as always, see you next time.